Hey guys, it's Vicky, and today I'm here with another Flicks and Lit video for you. And today I'm going to be talking about the film adaptation of the novel Revolutionary Road by Richard Yates. So Revolutionary Road, the novel, tells the story of April and Frank Wheeler, who are living in 1955 Connecticut, and they are basically living your typical suburban American lifestyle. Two kids, nice little house in a suburb. Frank works in the city, April is a housewife, but though they are living the idyllic sort of American dream, they are not happy with their lives. They are very upset with how they are living in the sense that they feel like they aren't doing anything exceptional. They feel like they're just cookie cutters of everyone else around them, and they felt like they should have been living a more exciting or interesting life. And so, because they are so unhappy in their lives, they come up with this plan, which I won't say what it is, but it's a plan that they think is going to make them happier in their life and make them kind of feel like they're busting out of this conformity sort of situation that they're living in. So the novel basically tells you how that plan goes for them. And some of the challenges that they face. So as you guys know, if you saw my 5-star prediction wrap-up that I just did, you know that the novel Revolutionary Road didn't really wow me. It was a 3-star read. I think that though I thought the writing was really good and I really enjoyed the themes, how it talked about, you know, being at that point in your life where you feel like you should have done more or that you had wanted to do more or feeling like you're living this life that just isn't making you happy, even though society's telling you that you should be happy with the life you're living. I really enjoyed those themes. However, the characters in the book, April and Frank, especially Frank, were not my type of characters. I did not enjoy them. And I know that I do like unlikable characters, you know, in a story, but for some reason in this one, it just didn't work for me, and I really feel like it was detrimental to my enjoyment of the book overall, because I think by the end of the story, you are really supposed to sympathize with Frank and April, and I had a hard time doing that because of the way that they were as characters. I just felt like they came across as very snobby, very egotistical, it just seemed like they looked down on everybody else, like they were so much better, like they were so special, when really they weren't. They were just normal, average people who had it in their head that they were super special and deserved so much more. And so it just sort of rubbed me the wrong way. So I went into the movie hoping that Kate Winslet and Leonardo DiCaprio were going to make those two characters a little more likable for me and make me sympathize with them a little bit more, and I'm super happy to say that they did that. And that's the first thing that I have to talk about in this film adaptation is how good the acting is. Kate and Leo, man, did they act well in this movie. They were so good together, and it's no secret that they have great chemistry on screen. And man, it shows in this, even though they are playing a husband and wife who are very unhappy in their life in general, but also with each other, they're very combative in this story. And it's just, it gets pretty ugly. And just the way that they played those characters together and acted off of each other, it was fantastic. So I'm happy to say that their acting saved this for me, which was what I was hoping. I know Kate won an award for her performance, but Leo was so good too. There's a scene at the end where he gets super emotional, and it blew my mind. There were some other great actors in this movie as well. Kathy Bates, who was always great, played one of their neighbors. I can't remember what her name is now. But anyways, she plays one of their neighbors, and also David Harbour is in this movie and it plays another neighbor. If you guys don't know who that is, that's Hop from Stranger Things, who I love. And he's so young and stuff in this movie and looks a lot different, plays a totally different character, but it was fun to see him in a different role. As far as the adaptation goes, I feel like they followed the book pretty much to a T. There was some background information that they kind of took out, a few other details that maybe were spent on a little more in the book, they kind of took out, and that was fine. I was totally fine with it. sometimes even down to the dialogue was exactly the same. So I mean, in terms of the screenplay, it was the book pretty much. As far as the ending went, there were a few minor changes to the way the book ended. One detail especially that was in the book that they took out of the movie that I was kind of surprised that they took that detail out, because it did sort of have an impact on the other characters, this minor detail. So I was a little surprised that they took it out, but obviously it wasn't really missed that much. It didn't change anything really. But yeah, I mean, otherwise it was a clear-cut adaptation. And I have to say that by the end of the movie, I definitely did feel more for these characters, and the ending affected me more in the film. And it probably has to do with, again, the acting, but also I wanted to mention the score in this movie. I didn't have it written down who did the score, but the score in this movie is great and just perfectly helps tell that story. And I think towards the end, as the ending happens, that coupled with the score, it was great. It was very effective for me emotionally. It affected me way more than when I read the book. So yeah, overall, I think this is one of those instances, and I'm not surprised by this because when I read the book, I had a feeling I was gonna like the movie more, and I definitely do. Again, I'm gonna really chalk it up to Kate and Leo's performances in this movie. They were so good. They really just brought something else to the characters that I felt they were lacking in, or maybe that I just read differently when I read the novel. But in here, they just seem more human, and you just identify with them better. So yes, overall, this was a great film. Though I would say, if you're interested in reading the book, definitely check it out, because Richard Yates is a great writer. I do have to say his writing was good. It was just these characters that I struggled with, and I definitely want to read some of his other work. But the movie, for sure. Definitely, if you've read the book and you're curious, you need to watch the movie. It's great. It's great. All right, guys, so let me know down below if you have seen the film Revolutionary Road, read the book, or both. I would love to hear what your thoughts were on the adaptation. Yes, it was a good movie. I can see why it was an award winner or why it was nominated for things, because it was a great film. So, yeah, and also, as I always say in my Flicks and Lit videos, let me know down below if you have any future Flicks and Lit ideas or requests, because I would love to do more of these videos for you. So that's all I have for today, guys. I hope you are having a wonderful day, and I will talk to you soon. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.